Hopefully we're live, and good evening, ladies and gentlemen. It's time to check out a bit of Hellion. I've been kind of keen on this one. It's got a bit of a horror vibe. I don't know, darkness of space and all that sort of stuff. So without further ado, you guys can just confirm that my levels are nice for me and nothing's too interfering. I think we should probably kick off with the intro because it might help explain a little bit what the hell is going on. We shall see. So, we've got this all set up. I apologize if this is very loud. Some of the volume levels in this game so far seem to be interesting, like you can't turn the music off, but we'll give it a go. So, stop the music, hit the play button, because I know the intro starts immediately.
It was the dawn of the 23rd century when mankind finally dared leave the confines of Earth. With the last of the Unification Wars behind them, fusion power and interstellar travel in their hands, they turned their attention to a distant star. They named it Hellion. Work began on the Expedition Project, a massive undertaking with a singular purpose: to give humanity a new home beneath an alien sky. The journey will take almost a century.
Hey guys, good evening. Welcome all to a little bit of Hellion. Apologies for some slightly dodgy starting of the stream there. I have no idea what was going on. I click start and then it doesn't start. So hopefully at least we are now live and I can give you a bit of the Hellion goodness. Now, the reason you're looking at a static screen at the moment is because the very first thing that happens with this game is we get the intro, which hopefully will fill us in a bit with what the hell's going on, because this has got a weird darkness of space horror vibe that I'm quite looking forward to. So hey folks, I'm gonna keep kinda quiet and let you guys watch the initial intro so that we get an idea of what the hell is going on. So, fingers crossed, levels are good, this doesn't blast your ears out, let's give it a go. One of the things I've not been able to do properly is balance the volume in this, because it's got one volume slider that just says volume. That's not very helpful. Anyway, let's give this a try.
It was the dawn of the 23rd century when mankind finally dared leave the confines of Earth. With the last of the Unification Wars behind them, fusion power and interstellar travel in their hands, they turned their attention to a distant star. They named it Hellion. Work began on the Expedition Project, a massive undertaking with a singular purpose: to give humanity a new home beneath an alien sky. The journey would take almost a century.
It's all over. The Expedition has fallen apart. Hellion is a war zone.
Oh shit, that doesn't look good.
It was a mistake. It was insane right from the start. But we can't turn back now. I just pray
that doesn't sound good either. I get the impression something went a bit wrong with this little project here. Ironic that the company that made it is called Zero Gravity as well. So let's see what this is all about. Obviously, we are in the alpha version, so yeah, usual blah 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 blah, bugs. Don't take it at completely face value. Things are going to get changed. And the first thing I will have a quick look at is the options menu, because there are a few things in here that surprise me, one of them being your volume slider just says, where's the one for music so that I can turn your in-game music off and use mine? But there are a few options. One of the things I have noticed with this is it keeps forgetting options. So you can change all these options and it makes absolutely no difference, because it's going to turn them back off again as soon as it gets an opportunity to. So we can save that, but it doesn't seem to make any difference. And yeah, game options. There's not a huge amount going on in here, guys, to begin with, at least. What there is, however, and I've already set up a character, so we're called Wasted Space, and that's literally just give yourself a name, is a lot of servers, which is a nice thing to see literally on launch. Look at all these, all over the world as well. So you've got Australian servers. There's a bunch of custom servers come up recently as well, but we got stuff in the US, we got stuff in the UK, stuff around Europe. That's a really good sign. It means that hopefully once this list updates, I can get a nice like 4 millisecond ping or something ridiculous like that. But yes, the loose storyline of this, if you didn't pick up from the intro, is basically colony ships. We developed warp technology. We sent us like a massive colony ship off with millions of people on aboard it to settle what was supposed to be a system that was all ready for us. And everything was all ready and spanky and nice, and we were just going to show up at this utopia and it was going to be wonderful. And you can imagine exactly how well that went. So yeah, apparently it wasn't quite so wonderful as everyone hoped. Looks like a lot of the servers are offline at the moment. That's interesting. There are a few still up, so let's see if we can jump on to... Let's have a look. London 1. Create character. It's me. What said space? Good question. Good question. What did he say? And hey, guys. Everyone that's joining the stream. So, London Hellion server. Oh, dear. This is a bad sign. This is a bad sign for an initial early access launch, isn't it? This is why I knew it was a little bit brave to be starting off immediately. Let's see if we can get onto one of the servers that allows us to have a few more people. Nope! Servers are just going offline left, right and centre. Now, I checked this about half an hour ago and all of these servers were online, so I wonder if they've got some issues at the moment. Let's just find another server maybe that we can get into. Dear, oh dear. Does it just not like Wasted Space, perhaps? I know it's not up on Steam, but in reality, Zoklu, were you? It doesn't like the 4 in my name. That's all it was. Oh dear. Hang on, back. Let's find a better server. Is it really just it doesn't like the 4 in my name? It is, isn't it? It doesn't like the 4 in my name. Oh well. That's a start at least. We've found one thing that we know with Hellion so far, and that's special characters. Not allowed. Yes, it's multiplayer only at the moment, so there is no single player. I guess somewhere down the line you're allowed to have a private server as such. My mouse cursor's come up, which is a scary sign. That normally means that something in the background is busy crashing or something. No, maybe it's just got a very long load time. We shall have a look. No nums at the moment. Cheers, Zoc. Yeah, I know Zoklu was streaming this last night, so it definitely does work. We've checked this out from that respect already. I was kind of hoping this would be a smooth procedure. Oh, good old Forced Space. It is doing something. There was a little... Look, we got a little thing on my mouse cursor occasionally. Ah, the joys of early access games. So yes, we were supposed to arrive at this wonderful prepared place set around the star Hellion, and something went terribly wrong, as usual. And so that's basically where we're left. We've woken up around the correct star, but everybody's gone and everything's ruined. So yeah, interesting. We'll have to see how it goes. This is my first time playing the game, and my experiences so far, not looking ideal. It could be it has a very long load time. I'm going to give it a few more minutes. And if that doesn't work out, then I guess we're restarting. Also, this slightly ominous. I don't know. I imagine Salisbury Plain here. Stonehenge is involved. Sadly, I was busy last night, Zoc. I would have loved to. What do you reckon, guys? Has it crashed? Is this a dead server? Is this not working? Is this a live server? Should I have just stuck on the server I was on? Maybe that was a more sensible thing to have done. Let's try this again. Bye-bye, Hellion. One more shot, shall we? Terribly Wrong is perfect for survival games, to be honest. Yep, it's that loud intro again. No, skip it. Skip it fast. All right, let's give this another shot. It was an empty server, I thought. No, it had four people on it, didn't it? It had a few guys on it. This server list takes a while to update, which is a bit of a shame. It's crashing the shaders, says Jimpyu. Fair enough, maybe. Yeah, Zark, we definitely do have to play this together sometime. I mean, this looks like one where potentially we could get the whole community together. Like, you know, while the servers are only 30 men, that's still... Look, there's a 100-man server there. Can you imagine the Discord community all playing Hellion together? That could be awesome. Set up some really, really cool, just scenario-based servers or scenario-based activities, be it fighting, trading, whatever. This game's supposed to have quite a large sort of realm of different possibilities once we get somewhere down the line. So, more offline servers. Look, they've got tiny pings. London 11. That's got to be good. I'm connecting to a server that is literally less than 20 miles from me. So, we should be good. Ooh. Here we go. We're good. So, I can have a fresh start. Wake up after a century in cryo, just one of the many colonists on their journey to Hellion. As your consciousness returns and you finally open your eyes, you find yourself in a small module. Barely even a lifeboat. Oh! A random shack appears. Yeah, indeed. Do you imagine 100 people on a server with the Discord guys? It'd be crazy. Utterly mad. We can pick off where we left off. I don't think we did left off. Or we can go to a random outpost. One part of a massive complex, now just a remnant of an old conflict. Somehow, station systems are still operational, and there are signs of a recent struggle. You cannot explain how, but you know that you are not safe here. That does sound slightly cool. I'm pretty tempted to go with the old random outpost here. Let's give it a go. Am I in? This is another loading screen. We've not necessarily got that. This one's got no spooky sounds. I could put my music on, but I'm concerned that that's going to completely break the mood because I don't have particularly mysterious music. Quite calm and gentle music, but not mysterious music. Life! We're in a thing. It appears to have semi-frozen. Nope. We're alive. I can look around. Is there any survival game where you don't start off in some sort of pod? Either one that has crashed, or one that's in a broken ship, or one that's being torn open by aliens. It's all the same. F to interact. I pressed F, the game froze for a second, and then went, sure. This has got a sort of crisis-y sort of vibe. Not crisis, what am I talking about? It would be crisis. A bit of a Star Citizen-y sort of vibe, just with the ability to see yourself and the way you're getting into that. That's sort of a very low polygon, low shader level crisis. Sensitivity is ridiculous. Controls, sensitivity. Don't tell me it's already at the lowest. Oh, come on. Don't be doing that. That's not acceptable. Oh, God help us if you want to add it on 10. Ah! Right. We've also don't appear to have any music, so I can press play at least. Changing the sensitivity causes quite a bit of lag, even though I didn't change it. So what we got? Environmental control. Bar of pressure. We have gravity. Good quality air. 28 degrees. Quite warm. What's that? Warning. Disable life support. Prevents air pumping in the current room. And everything's on standby. Okay. Interesting. Let's have a bit of a look around. Certainly got some air filtering on the go. I wonder, do you think it's gone back to the bad video settings again? Yeah, it has. Look. It loves to just reset its video settings for no reason. Yes, I do. Very high. Does that look any better? Not really. Okay, so what have we got in here? Life support nodes. F to interact with life support node. What are we going to get? Working properly. Replacement advised. Effective. Okay, so that's the different part status, but how do I know which one it's on? Got a pressure regulator I can nab or put back. That's all fine and dandy, but I have no idea what to do with it. Let's try getting in. We don't have an inventory. Tab opens a menu that we have nothing in. These are all good starting. Air generator. They're going to do this all with colours, aren't they? Which is going to drive me utterly nuts. Utterly nuts. It is kind of Minmatar interior. The bare fans everywhere, kind of. It's got a certain style, and the chicken wire. Well-known use in spacecraft. Quick, get the chicken wire out. That'll sort it. Right, let me out of this place. Oh, nice. Warning, pressure hazard. Oh, apparently I didn't need the manual override. All right then, fine. No gravity in here. And actually a pressure hazard, so that must go outside? Wow. Okay, cool. Yes, that does go outside. Moving around in zero-G is about as intuitive as it is in Star Citizen as well. As in, you feel like you're not moving around in zero-G, you're moving around in soup, primarily. Very, very thick soup. Okay. What's we got in here? Things! A large med pack, I probably want one of them, and a warp cell. No slot. Can I drag this off into slots for things? No? Don't have an inventory. Let's med myself, why not? It seems to be there for a purpose. Warp cell seems like a helpful thing to have. Where do I put it? There's got to be a place to put a warp cell, right? That looks like a warp cell sort of opening. No, that's an air filter, apparently. Whoop. Okay, pretty cool. However, not where I put a warp cell. What we got down here? All sorts of stuff. No easy way of placing this down. Let's have a look at the controls. Okay, what have we got? Forwards, backward, all the usual. Drop throw is G. Change stance. That's all very armor. On Earth. Melee, important. To change stance is Z. Rather violently throw that around. So we got an ore canister, servo motors, resource injectors. Surely a resource injector was what I was missing from our life support node. No, it was a pressure regulator. There was definitely a resource injector around here somewhere. Aha! No slot. Oh, wow. Is this just going to be throwing things on the floor and picking them up again, simulator? That does not look the same as that. It's clearly yellow, so it's not working, but... So, air processor, servo motor. There you go. Put it in there. That did nothing. Has it come out now? You get inventory by putting on a suit. I should really have a better look around, shouldn't I? Life support's off. What have we got through here? Let me out. Still got gravity this way, at least. That's something. Cool. See, the thing with space stations is they pack things in quite tightly, if they're sort of realistically built, in such a way that it's very hard to find anything. So that's Dock B, Dock A, Dock C. Nothing indicated as to where these actually lead. Surely there's got to be a spacesuit in here somewhere. This is a station. Not allowed out through there, because... It is pressurized. But it's zero-G and leads outside again. Yeah, I need a suit to get inventory, but I don't, at this point at least, totally understand what it is that I'm supposed to be actually achieving. Clearly I want to try and repair that life support, but... You got these pressure regulators and air filter units. And is it the coloration that indicates whether they're broken or not? I imagine it is. Air filtering standby, pressure regulation standby. It's just disabled. There's somewhere around. Can I just turn it on? Roll up cabinets. Those are apparently things I can interact with. Oh, yeah. Ah, to equip an EVA suit and a helmet. Nice. Oh, yes. So now I actually have inventory slots and places I can put things for... Cool. Okay, that makes more sense. So is there really any purpose behind repairing this station? Or should we... Or
even looking, we might as well look around the station, check there's nothing else kicking around. Like, what's in there? Why is that room different? Let me in. Oh, this means we can go up? Looking around, the sensitivity is really weird. There's a ladder there that we can't interact with. Ooh. And a ceiling. Yes, my problem with good being green, yellow being maybe red being dead, is when you're red-green colorblind and so struggle with all variations of color between red and green, it makes that sort of signal system quite annoying when they're very small. I can barely turn in this thing. This is kind of soupy. But we've got a door here once I've finally managed to pull ourselves around. Maybe that's why the sensitivity's got the range it does, is because as soon as you're in space, it's utterly horrid. Let me out, goddammit. Do you fall on your face? No, we don't do a starter zone. Gunnery control is out of order. That is a shame. Mainframe? Hell yeah. Computers? I assume they're computers. What do you got? Recharge station for rifle battery or jetpack? I apparently don't have any of those, but there are some bits kicking around. Servo motor. EM field controller. Now, we definitely saw somewhere we might be able to place one of those sort of chip things earlier downstairs. So that might be worth having a look at. There's another helmet up here for some reason, same as the one we've got. X to take the helmet off again. I am wasting oxygen. Okay. Oh god, what have I done? You say X to take it off again. I'm pressing X, it doesn't do anything. Has that taken it off? It's very hard to tell. It doesn't look like it has. So how do I... Can I just drop it in my backpack, maybe? Nope. Make a jetpack. I'm trying to find out what's going on around here first. I need to find some working panels. Figure out... What's this? Distress beacon? Probably a bad plan. Wow, this station's a lot bigger than it appears from where I was. How do we get to those other bits? Or are we in a broken off bit or something? Oh, hello. Hello. Rifle. That's the same suit we've got. Yeah. Is that a jetpack? That's a jetpack. I'm holding R, and it says I'm full. Is that not where a jetpack should go? Don't take off the helmet, just pull up the visor. Everyone's giving me good suggestions. The problem is, what the blooming controls are for these things is slightly less obvious, because there really isn't that many controls. I have equipped the helmet, definitely. I've definitely equipped the helmet. I'm going to put this thing down for a second. Clearly I do want it, but I also want to go and charge up my rifle. How do I equip the rifle? It's there. This is a recharge station for it. But it's not a rechargeable rifle. Uses... No, it's not a rechargeable one. Oh, there we go. That's quite cool. So is that now just recharging it and I have to leave it there for a bit? Is there a visual indicator somewhere? Okay, so I can put the jetpack on. It appears to be fully charged though, and for some reason holding R to equip just brings up the thing that says full. Visor is R, visor is X. How can it be R and X? Ah, I have the wrong suit. Okay. So let's drop that suit. Let's grab this. Is this the suit I need, perhaps? That's an AltCorp jetpack. This is an AltCorp suit. Which is the one I'm wearing. Yeah. This is the one I'm already wearing, so I'm a bit confused there. And the gun's apparently full power already. Fine. Let's get out of here then. The jetpack refuses to equip. I think I've grabbed everything that was of use in here. No solar panels, no fusion reactor. Okay. I do have a Discord. It's all linked down below. Well, I do have a Discord. We do have a Discord. It's a community one between three YouTubers, in fact. And the plan, I think, will be eventually for us to get together in something like this and do some crazy stuff, whatever that might be. I'm trying to figure out what on earth the crazy stuff is supposed to be at the moment. God, that sensitivity is horrible. So, this is another one of those life support notes. There was a life support computer. Can I just go and turn the life support computer on? Pretty sure it was back in this room. I also failed to check this box completely as well. Boxes are full of useful things, apparently. Like air filter units and pressure regulators. That one was working, these ones are working, so I assume by what you guys are saying that these ones aren't. Sure, we need that at the moment. Life support. Offline. Why are you offline? Confusing system. Ah, right. We're offline because one of these is broken in the air filter. Now, one of those looks like one of the things we have in this box over here. Air processor. Yep. So now all I need to do is figure out which air filter it is. Is it this one? J to turn gravity on and off by room basis. That seems wonderfully unnecessary. Was it the air filter I needed to put it in? Let me go and check that again. I'm probably being stupid. It's my usual game. Be really, really dumb. That tends to help. I can't interact with stuff in your hand. That's... Well, there was another rifle here, and in fact, there was plenty of stuff here. What's this? Another blooming helmet as well. So, yeah, the air filter is missing a thing. Is it missing a carbon filter? Is that what it's saying? Yeah, it's missing a carbon filter. So, in fact, it's not missing an air processor at all. I'm terrible. Oops. I might have thrown that through the box. Nothing we saw there. What is this? Tell me what they are. None of those look like carbon filters. They look, yeah, servo motors. That seems messed up as well. So let's drop that out. I swear I had a spare working one of these. I might have put it in the inventory. Yeah. This chance to work out how the inventory works. There you go. How do I put it back in my hand now? It's now gone from that list. What have I done with it? Did I just drop it on the floor? I don't think so. It's a slightly confusing control system, I've got to say. Got an EM field controller. That's not what we were after. It has a carbon filter, the air filter just isn't turned on. It's got all these bits, none of them seem to be a power button. I can take them, put them back in him. That one's fine. Is that broken? Drag stuff to the center. I'm stuck. No, I'm not. I'm unstuck. The upper part of the maintenance screen, there was an explanation of it. Okay. As I said, part of my issue is that I struggle with the actual colours themselves, it seems. What's this stuff on the wall there? Another distress. Does seem to be. Oh, I'm getting stuck on a wire on the floor. That's what's happening. Okay. What's down here? Except for no gravity. I like that there's
bars on the walls that you should, in theory, be using to pull yourself around. Yeah, virtual gaming. I would be pretty screwed otherwise. Lots of help from chat. I have found a vent that doesn't take me anywhere interesting. Quick, out of the vent again. Now we're here, at this place. Lots of detail. Also quite confusing. The ship's not powered. Okay, so I'm looking for a power terminal. Where on earth do I find a power terminal? It's none of these ways. Let's try and find one of the routes that we haven't been yet. There were a couple. I have no idea where that vent takes us. That's not something we can open, is it? That's not a power terminal. We had a power terminal and it said that we didn't have any generation. My helmet isn't on. I think it is. I've got the little reflections in the corners. I think my helmet is on. There was a carbon filter, yeah, I know. I'm just going to have a look around now. I've had enough of messing around in that place. It doesn't actually seem to make... Why am I repairing the life support? Why do I care? What is in this place that means that I want the life support working? We don't know yet. So let's go and cargo interaction panel. Give me all of your cargo. It's got RCS propellant, nothing else. In here, what do we got? That looks like a different suit. Oh, hello. We've got a pressurized suit and an EVA suit. If I was more intelligent, I'd be able to tell you what the difference are. This room's pressurized, apparently. Oh, hello. This looks more like it. Samuel Kirby, I'm confused by what's going on as well. Artificial gravity control. Cool. Docking control. So that clearly goes outside. What on earth? Oh, cool. Drill, asteroid scanner. I think these are things I want, right? Batteries. Nice. Canister not attached. Right, okay. I need a canister for this as well, apparently, to store my warp cells. Singularity cell detonator. This isn't confusing in the slightest. There's a gun. Servo motors. Yes, that's what was confusing me. Neferum Gaming, surely... Aha! I am mining equipped. Why this matters? I don't know. X should open my helmet visor. Yeah, I was trying that and it didn't do anything. Yeah, it's not. Does this helmet visor just not open? This is out of order, whatever it is. A cargo interaction panel next to it doesn't help. Door control. Gudunk. That doesn't look good. That's got the definite look of you're not very healthy. So is an EVA suit somehow not pressurized? Because I'm really not looking very well here. Like, really not very well. Like, quick, get me to a place with some oxygen. Well. Yeah. I can hear my heartbeat now. Alright, and now we're into an environment with some more. So an EVA suit isn't pressurized. How on earth is that the case? And I've just dropped a battery through the floor. By accident. Oh, there it is. Okay, so I actually need that pressurized suit. However, how to go about equipping it is a far more difficult thing. There we go. I found out how to take my helmet off.
There's the pressurized one I want. Still can't equip it, though. How do I now? Why won't it now let me equip this? I thought I took off the suit I was wearing. Like, there's nothing here now that would suggest that I can take off anything further. This game is a little on the confusing side. There's a remove outfit button that doesn't do anything. And looks like very much of an afterthought as well. Maybe I can't equip it because I have stuff in my EVA suit. That could be a case. I'm willing to believe that. Let's chuck that down. And that sounded scary. Probably that's not the problem. Let's put that back where it was. But this stuff might be. In before I lose all of this stuff through the floor now. Go on. Right. Where to do... Right. There's the suit. Give me the suit. Nope. My word. Hey! CO2 filters. I know a place where I needed these. I've definitely still got my suit on because of this inventory section. How do you take it off then? It's not this remove outfit button. Nope, none of these things work. God. I've been holding R. It's very hard to... sort of for you guys to see when I'm holding R, etc. But right, I'm going to hold R really hard. Look, listen. That's me hitting R as hard as I can, and I'm holding it still. Holding the button. Put the damn thing on, goddammit. It says hold R to equip in the middle of the screen. Of course I clicked hold R. I'm still holding R at the moment, by the way. It gives me a perfect opportunity to open this can of drink. While I hold R. Hold R for the win. I'm still holding. I'm holding for all I'm worth. I did check the controls as well. The controls are woefully limited as far as... Right, there is no... That's it. That's all there is, guys. Lean controls, interact, drop throw, reload. Doesn't say anything about opening and closing your helmet, etc., your visor. That's a bit on the confusing side. Right, what I'm going to do is not bother about that and instead have a different mission. Let's grab these CO2 filters because there was actually a purpose for them. Small med pack, probably need that now. There's some bits and bobs around. I'm going to pick this stuff up and basically we're going to go and try and fix what we were trying to work on earlier. Where's that med kit? I think I might want to use that. I'm breathing in a way that doesn't sound very healthy. Does that help? Not really. We tried to get a jetpack and it wouldn't let me equip it. Same problem. Like, we found the jetpack earlier. I think we... Wait! We do start, isn't it? Straight into the floor, facepalm for the win. Does that gun look different? Military railgun sniper, damn right it looks different. You can actually carry two weapons as well. That's pretty sweet. So, all I've really done so far is find guns. Guns for the goodness. Right, let's go see if we can fix that air life support, whatever it was. That's not the right way. Thanks for the help, Elijah. I will try that once I've gone, and while I'm down here, I might as well, once I remember which one of these is the correct way to go, might as well try and stick these CO2 things in the life support that was broken. Just figure out if that's even something that happens. Oh, blooming hell. Where's this? This place is confusing. I need to get the pressure suit on first. It wasn't letting me. That's our biggest problem. But yes, once I've done apparently looking around down here. These are all running. But that resource injector is not. Aha! Now I can't interact. Did I just break it somehow? Do the fresh start, you reckon, Miles? There's two jetpacks on and I need the EVA one. I will admit that this is pretty confusing, and maybe the fresh start would have been a better introduction to what the hell's going on. So we're back into the central area. Now the suit we wanted was up here. I must have a jetpack of some sort on, otherwise how on earth am I controlling myself in those environments without touching the side? Oh no, this is where we found the jetpack. Right, so here's our jetpack, Alt-Corp jetpack, which is supposed to go with the Alt-Corp EVA suit, surely. So we pick this thing up and we hold R, and it says I'm full. And that's clearly the slot it's supposed to go in. So it must be the suit in this case. All right, everyone's saying fresh start. Sure. Let's give it another go. I assume respawn won't give me the option, so let's just reconnect. Holy crap, Space Engineers looks amazing now. Yeah, it really improved. So it does remember what servers you've been playing on, which is nice. Of course, Sergeant Viper. That's my game. Head first in. Head first in. Until you're so confused that you're like, oh god, what's going on? And then you can abandon ship and try again. Are you going to update these servers? Look how many more people there are playing already. This is crazy. There we go. Okay, that literally just... Is there no way to respawn? Can I not just... Yeah. This got released today. Clicking respawn just kicks you off the server. Interesting. Either that or it's going to make me reconnect to the server again for doing that. Hey, Saki. Is that Jay-Z watcher in chat? Jay-Z, I should say. I always say Jay-Z, why do I do that? Hellion got released 45-ish minutes ago, something like that. All available on Steam now. Information is down in video description, stream description, whatever you might call it. And at some point, this is going to load and let me do a fresh start. Whoop! Okay. This is looking very much like my other start so far. But let's see. No, it is different. It is different. We are not in the same place. And motion blur has turned itself on. No, I... Oh, hang on. Have I got these completely backwards and that's on? Shadow quality has dropped to high again for no reason. Look. Stop changing the graphic settings on your own! I didn't ask you to. Oh, I had it backwards. Now it looks anti-aliased as all hell. Quick, turn the anti-aliasing off before something horrible happens. Save. Does it look worse with better graphic settings? Or is it just me? What do you reckon, guys? Worse? Better? I am not sure. That was certainly blurry as all hell. Right. What's in the box? Broken components. I assume you can repair components eventually, otherwise what would be the point in having broken or semi-broken ones? Our power supply. We have no exposure to our solar panels. This is our problem. We have no consumption either, which is probably a good thing. Door control. What's through here? Outside is clearly through there. Back. Negnol, definitely. I'll be playing with Zoc a ton, because Zoc's awesome. And if he's also playing this, then sweet. Okay, so we've got ore canister for mining. Interact with... I can't see what that button does. It is a distress call button. Let's not interact with that. Spare filters. Cargo attachment point for cargo injection. Environmental controls in there. What's in the box? Meds. That makes sense. Here we have life support. Life support is broken. We are missing carbon filters. Number two carbon filters, no less. I am learning. The solar panels are not extended. Okay, interesting. Let's go and have a look at... Where was it? It's over here. Sun coverage suboptimal. So if that's clicked, that's extending the solar panels. That's really, really, really not very clear. I'm just saying. Like, there's one thing you do know about when you go in space. They wouldn't just have that in any realistic scenario to indicate that your solar panels are out. They just wouldn't. Oh, suits. Suits! Give to me the suits and let me put them on. Am I allowed to put... I can put a jetpack on. Oh, goddamn. It's about as exciting as it gets. So if I put this on and press X, hey guys, look. Everything you've been telling me works in this one. Oh god. I don't know if that makes me feel more or less thick. I'm not sure. So this is our air filter. Does that mean she's functional? Should be able to find out by looking at the life support. Where's our life support thing? Can I not interact with that? Warning, disabled life support. So our life support is turned off for some reason. Somewhere around there will be a life support panel. That's the cargo. Does this go anywhere that's inside? No, this goes outside as well. What are we in? Just a tiny little escape pod of some sort? I feel a lot better now. I something's actually happening. Somewhere around there should be a life support panel, and I'm just being blind at seeing it. Part status. That is working, right? These colors are screwing with my brain. There's our life support node, same as before. That looks like it's not working. That looks like it's orange to me. Is that our pressure regulators replacement advised? My ship is outside the survival pod. Okay, so I should just grab some mining equipment and get out there. Is there mining equipment about? I saw a cargo contact canister. That one. One would assume that somewhere around there's some mining equipment to go with it. Or anything? Any equipment to go with it? Or should I just fuck off outside and see what's going on? Let's fuck off outside and see what's going on. Let me out! To space! Wow, flares are plenty there. Mr. Abraham's back once again. Boo! I thought I pulled that. I just pulled one dock. I'm doing the wrong thing. Dock. There's nothing docked there. This side. Whoop. Jetpack is turned off. Oh, probably shouldn't take my helmet off. How do I turn my jetpack on? There we go. Why does it not tell you the controls? Why do you have to guess all the controls? Why is this necessary? I've shot myself out to lose gravity all over again. Yeah, I may be fucked. How do I... There was no obvious depressurization. I forgot to shut the door behind me. I assumed it would automatically... Because it opened automatically, why would it not shut automatically? Let's have a look. So there's an engine toggle. Engine toggle is return and not T. T is melee. I'm sorry, I can quite happily continue to complain about the controls, all the while they lie to you about them. I have to add the airlock module. Okay. Everyone's like, say goodbye to wasted ship. We're fine. I might kill myself smashing into it, however. Or maybe not. There we go. Right. Somewhere around here, apparently, is a ship of mine. People were saying my starter ship is outside. The door's shut. Yeah, I just needed to find the depressurize button. That was all. Everyone's like, death. No, no death. So there's a starter ship around, apparently. Oh, was there? A dev let's play. Okay, that explains why some people are a bit more clued up than I am. This to me looks like a ship itself. Looks pretty damn cool as well. The graphics in this are quite nice, especially now I've got outside. Oh, so it's just a docking thing. Ah, okay. So somewhere around there was a proper airlock. It's on the right side of the door. No, this game is not free. Let's go back outside and see if we can find the... Back inside and see if we can find the proper one. Okay, now I should be able to safely open this. At worst... Oh no, it's because we don't have working life support, so we can't pressurize. Our environmental control's fucked. So we have to depressurize rooms into rooms in order to get in and out. Excuse me. There was a solid door there. Excuse me. God damn it. Oh, God. Yeah, I want to fix the air filters, but I need to get back into the ship. Can I be allowed back into my ship, please? Just a little bit would be nice. Oh, now the entire damn station's depressurized. Why is this door now automatic? What? God's sake. No, don't open it again. Close the door. Close the panel. Go nowhere near the door. Fix the blooming air filter so that we can breathe. Okay. I want to breathe, please. It's even harder to see whether or not this shit is working like this. I think that's okay. Let's go and... But did we ever find the life support panel? I don't think we did. Pressure regulation is offline. What are you? You're a resource injector, you know. So the pressure regulator is over here. I'm pretty certain of that. That's an air... Yeah, this is the pressure regulator. You are apparently broken. Let me find a pressure regulator that is not broken. That is pressure regulator that is not broken. Where are you? There we go. In the hole. Shut the thing. Other side of the power screen. Uh-huh. Good spot. So what's the problem here? Missing carbon filters from the air. Okay. Did I pick up working ones? Don't know. Didn't check. Okay. So carbon, that's in a good nick. And that's in good nick. How are we looking? Everything's on. Offline, standby. Online. Glorious oxygen! Glorious oxygen! Yes, I am colorblind. I can't take my helmet off yet, and it's making the things even worse. We are starting to build up a bit of air pressure in the room, however. I believe that has the life support online. I believe. Yeah, there's a bit of pressure building up in the room. Things are happening. Air filter's on standby, but that's fine. I fixed the thing! Yeah! I know my oxygen is going, but I need the air quality in here to raise enough that I can take my thing off. I don't think I can charge it while it's on, can I? That is rising, right? It's really hard to tell. If I had a mouse, I'd put it on the screen at the edge and be like, that is rising, right? It's definitely outputting. I'm finding all sorts of new interfaces. It's wonderful. This isn't good, is it? Like, oxygen low, and the oxygen the pressure in here is not building up as fast as perhaps one might like. It's not great, right? I don't want to die. By the way, your tank on the base is dropping at a severe crease. Holy shit, what's wrong with the tank? Is the room, like, somehow not sealed? The room is sealed, right? I think it's breathable. It says it's not breathable. It's gotta be breathable. I'm not dying. The power's on. The power's definitely on. Online. Oh. Doll. Really? What difference does that make? If anything. Pressure regulation is offline. Why is pressure regulation offline? What's happened? I'm going to die again. This is all working. Pressure regulation isn't offline. Leave me alone. I don't want to die. I looked at the thingy on the screen. It says unbreathable. Disabled life support prevents air pumping in current room. Why? Online. On standby, I assume, because it's got no reason to be online. It's the air filter. What I could do, I suppose, is drop this thing and grab a fresh jetpack with a fresh oxygen supply in it. Yeah. But we need to apparently sort out the oxygen problem in here, and I have no idea how to go about doing that. Because game is confusing. Very confusing. Shit, so I need to go outside and get some stuff, but there's no mining equipment in here that I can see. So I guess I'm just going to have to jump out the airlock and hope. That seems to be about the deal. That seems to be about my only hope, because there's nothing else going on in here. The boxes are full of parts for stuff that I don't need. Oh, hang on. I can hang that up and hope that it recharges. It's not, but scrap this ship, they reckon. How do you scrap the ship? And someone's saying in chat, don't bother to try and dock, guys. It's broken / bugged. That's a pressure hazard on its own. I can't even get out of the ship safely. Don't jump, there are doors in the roof. There aren't doors in the roof. Not that I can see. Are you making it up? You're making it up as you go along. There are no doors in the roof. Those are fans. There is a ship outside. All right, we're going out. If I die, I die. Let me out of the fucking room. Come on. Pull the lever. You cannot. You're supposed to go outside and attach the airlock by docking, but the docking procedure is bugged. As is my manual override button. Power is online. We're getting power. However, I am not allowed to open the door. I'm going to turn life support off again, because it doesn't seem to be doing anything useful anyway. And see if that lets me out. Put my helmet on. No, I can open and control the hatch, but I'm not actually allowed out that door anymore. Wonderful. How about this one? This one works. I'm probably going to, Garrett. I would just want to... People are suggesting I restart, basically, which is a good idea. This is a confusing game, and what I should do is try and turn around so that I can shut this door behind me somehow. Is there some way of making sure that this door is shut and we don't lose what little air we've got left? Like that. That would be good. That would be good. Open up the puppy! Let me out! Ready? Pew! Okay. People say to the right of the door, we might be in luck and have a ship. I'm not seeing anything. Unless the ship doesn't look like a ship. And then maybe it is here. Is that a ship? Looks a bit weird. Potentially the most ship-like structure so far on this thing. Use the radar to find it. Press K. Ship 2.4 kilometers. Okay. That's this one. So that's definitely this one. So there's a ship 2.5 kilometers that away. Oh, I see it. It appears to be moving. Either that or there's a bit of jittery weirdness at this sort of distance. Let's go check it out. Floating through space. This is apparently taking a while. I don't understand how we can... That thing must be moving, because... Look at the difference in distance we're traveling from the ship we were in versus towards that one. Weird. K is apparently radar. Okay, another one that you'll notice is not in here. Is any of the keys K? Nope. No K in here. Please, 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 please don't have lots of keys in your game that aren't explained. Be very nice. It is moving, but it does look like a ship. It is getting a bit jittery. I don't know why. I don't know if it's lag or what. The stream's fine, right? Look at all this desync. I guess that's what it is. What is causing that? Because that's kind of sickening. All right, I'm now apparently traveling towards it, even though the, like, particle indicators on the screen would not suggest that. I'm aware I have to match speed, but I'm not moving away from it. I'm moving towards it now. However, the particles don't seem to indicate movement quite right. And there's that weird jerkiness. Right, I think I'm going dead on. This game is forced online, yes. There are only online servers, multiplayer only. Incoming. I'm probably going a bit quick, so let's try and counteract my movement already. I'm going really quick. Like I somehow sped up as I was getting closer, which is impressive. Rubber banding, left, right, and center. However, oh, and a bit of Abrams for good measure. It's a ship, folks, right there. And I have half my oxygen jetpack left. Oh, perfect music timing. As I try and get on board. Hello, friend. You gonna let me in? Pressure hazard. This is really hard to match speeds with. Boop, 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 boop. No? Can't press that to interact. Seems broken. Is there a manual override? Doesn't appear to be a manual override either. It's pressurized in there. I'm just not allowed to open it. Let me in, goddammit! Alright, let's have a look around the ship then. There's got to be another way in. Oh, hello. What we got here? Solar panel utility access. Maybe it's got no power. Let's go and try and turn it on. What's going on here? Servo motor, and that seems to be about it. That doesn't seem to be the issue. That seems okay. So people are saying depressurize the room. I didn't see a depressurize button, but let me go and have another look. I am known to be highly blind, so no, I'm not seeing it, guys. I'm not seeing a big depressurize button unless it's on. Is it on the left side? Can I use this to depressurize? Oh, I can. Oh, I see. Not only that, but it holds me in position while it happens. Stressing people out. Too much clench. Too much clench. Oops. Now, how do I just escape to get off that? Okay. I was hoping for a more elegant control, but... And pressurizing. No manual override this time. Shift to grab onto stuff while floating. Wonderful. Thank you, Garrett. She's pressurizing. I reckon I can get away with the helmet off now. Nice. Still no grav, but hopefully if we just pop through this door here. Not opening for me for free? No? Okay. God, which way is up? Yeah, I had a feeling that might happen. Just like, hang on a second. That looks like the floor in front of me. That's probably not good. Are you not going to close yourself? Okay, there we go. We're in. Right, what's going on here? Power supply. Oh, I like how that drops down. Let's power up the solar panels. Get things up and running. What's going on here? Catalyzer. Can't actually interact with that, even though it suggests that it's... It looks broken to me. I don't know if that actually means it's broken. Online, we're a bit suboptimal, but that's something. What do we got? Let's turn on life support, can we? Nope, life support's fucked. Can't turn on engines either. They also need replacing. Yeah, everything. We can turn on capacitor. That's not helpful. Let's go repair some stuff, apparently. I'm breathing quite heavily at the moment. I can't help but notice. Let's grab a gun, sure. Yeah, what's with the massively thumping, not so happy... Not so sure about that. Something is... It's not oxygen or temperature. Everything's apparently fine. Let's deal with life support. Offline? No. Standby? Is there any reason why they would be... Oh, there we go. Okay. Standby. Any reason why these would only be on standby? Is that just because they're not needed, I guess? Our engines and so on. Turn the capacitor on to build up power. Okay. I suppose that makes sense, yeah. It's weird this doesn't auto open for me, but sure. Let's open it up. And our power bar thing was at the back. Capacitor on. Right, let's find the life support. I think that seems to be the next thing that we need to worry about. We've got life support modules around. I'd rather find the screen so I can work out what exactly is going on. Everything is functional there. Down here we have what? Windows? Scary. And seems to be about it. Can't go up that way. Why? Oh, pressing X by mistake. It does look like I'm blacking out, and I don't entirely know why it is I'm blacking out. Everything apparently is working except for the engines, which for some reason I can't turn on. Oh, the engines are on. Ignore me. Turn off the engine. Go to the bottom bit in the lift. I see no bottom bit. Alright, hang on a sec, guys. I'm going to need to take a quick be right back. One of my cats is causing a nightmare. Because that's what they're like, stupid moggies. Go on, XSplit. Let me open you so I can go to the be right back screen, please. XSplit's not quite up for that. 2 seconds, guys. Sorry about this. Thank you.
Okay, so I need to find the elevator. It's near where you got it on the same floor, and I also need to understand that the engines don't work at the moment. Fine. Understood. So, elevator is near where I got it on the first floor. Let's have a look. Somewhere around here is an elevator, apparently. Some suits, life support, air generator. I'm not seeing an elevator, guys. Am I really, really blind? Is it just this panel on the floor? That seems like the door control for that again, but maybe I'm wrong. Yeah, it says door control. Actually means elevator control, I would say. Oh, cool. So big cargo bay. Drills! And life support modules. And shit down here. All sorts of stuff. Okay, so we've got lots of stuff down here. I guess the first thing we should think about doing is mining, maybe? Because I can't... If engines don't work, so you can't fly ships around, then I guess that's the next thing to worry about, is like, what's resource gathering and so on, like that rack of batteries next to the mining equipment. I love it. My suit's so low, I need to... Okay, that makes sense. Well, the recharge point for it's here. I like how there's just a couple of weird-looking windows. It's my jetpack I technically need to recharge, I think. Can I not drop that in a weapon slot? I can, but I need to get rid of this thing. Can I that not go in? All right. Go away. I've been carrying you since the last spaceship. You're not actually necessary, thank you. Let's put this jetpack on there to recharge, and I'll go upstairs and grab one of the other ones that we already had. Oh, the ship does work. Okay. Someone was saying about engines not working. That was all. Okay, so another jetpack, so I'm fully set up. Apparently the ship does work, so let's go and sit in our seat if we can. Dum dum dum. Lots of looking. Oh, hello. Are we allowed to look outside? Wow, that is how your head moves around when you do this is really... What on earth? Yeah, this does not seem very healthy. I'm just saying... Get out of that. See, the engines are on, right? The engines are definitely on. Now it says cooldown. Whatever that means. Oh, inventory controls. Look, there's a button that gives you controls that they don't tell you about, I think. No, these are the same controls as in the control menu. That doesn't help. Not only that, but you can't get rid of it. Oh, okay. Oh, God. And now is that a graphical bug, or are we just in a funny position relative to the sun? No, it got very dark all of a sudden.
How can I be pushing the wrong buttons when flying? I'm looking around with the mouse. And it's making it move like this. This can't be intended. This is not pushing the wrong buttons, it's the mouse. Am I in RCS mode? Potentially. I have no idea how to change said things, because what they don't do in any of these menus is let me tell you how. I did the engine toggle. Keypad plus and keypad minus. Okay. For engine power, apparently. So I press enter and return. That does nothing. That control doesn't do what it says. Engines are now offline. Like, this is just me looking around. It does weird things. Hold alt. Yeah, alt looks around. But how do I control the craft around then? The game looks like it's got plenty of promise. It just, it at the moment, it's a bit obscure in some of its mechanics. And that includes, like, why on earth can't you just control the ship? It's weird. Need to interact with the seat rather than the panel. But from the seat, I can't. And I need to interact with the seat first and then the panel. And then I still get the slightly weird movement. Let's see if I can turn engines on now. The power's supposed to be on. There doesn't seem to be any fuel for them, but hey. We have RCS in theory. That's a bit broken. So that's what happens when you use RCS to travel around, basically, is that's what you get. So I can I change? Check contact changing as on new keys now. It was on the arrow keys, but that's now moved somewhere else. Need to fix the solar array. Okay. I know I've only got RCS. I'm just wondering why the controls are so weird and balky. Everyone says I need to fix the engines. The engines are on and supposedly working, according to the power supply at least. Not quality content, but I don't know what you want to say at this point. It's a first play, and this is what first plays are like. There are a lot of trying to figure out what the game's all about, and in this case, a lot of getting very confused as to, like, what on earth's going on with the mechanics. Why is it so dark in here now? Has it just turned my lights off? Did I turn my lights off? No, they're on. I'm generating power. One of my two solar panels wasn't on. Because, again, it's a bit of a weird... Why not have a more overall clear layout of what's actually on your ship? You know, an icon showing you your number of solar panels and whether they're deployed or not, and then some power underneath it, rather than this system where it, like... It's not even very clear to tell whether that's highlighted or not. A bit weird. Not that I suspect this makes any difference. It's still dark as hell in here. Turn engines off. Devs have them off because they're working out fuel issues. Okay. I will give that a try and see what happens. It is early access, and you've got to expect that. So part of the reason that I'm being critical is in sort of the hope that you can mention issues that can be addressed still. You know, it's not because I'm not sort of A, enjoying the game, because I'm actually finding it quite intriguing, but B, like, up for it improving. That's why I'm trying to suggest things that also contain a like, and you should do this with it, because then it would be more clear and more understandable. So the ship is, to some extent, a bit useless, because you've only got RCS, they're quite slow, and the way they work seems to throw the camera around, like, really badly, for some reason. Also, when I press forwards, it makes me go at negative meters a second. So I don't really know about that. I seem to lack actual control over my speed. Maybe that speed monitor thing is incorrect or something. I do seem to be moving quite quickly, I have to say. But, yeah. Getting out of seats is quite annoying as well, because you have to press escape to do it. I haven't found another way of doing it yet. However, what am I supposed to do then? What's our goal here? We've got some guns. I've got my mining equipment downstairs. Do I go and grab the mining equipment? We go and find something to mine and see if that works, I guess. Cool, Gasbonic Acid. I'll have to take a look at that. I played Minecraft way back when it was, I mean, early enough days that my brother keeps telling me that at one point we were actually playing on a server with Notch relatively often. I don't remember it to save my life, but he says that happened, so maybe it did. Somewhere around, I left a mining drill. I don't know where I left it, so I'm going to get another one. Because I'm that sort of guy. Head to the asteroid, attach everything. Yep, I'm going to attach this. Somewhere around there was a canister. Where did I put that? There it is. It's quite dark. I've turned some lights off somehow, or something. I don't know what's going on. The bloom has gone psycho crazy. That's what's happened. Okay. Oh, there's even a lock for the airlock. That's quite cool. What is that? Strange protrusion coming from my back. What is it? Oh well, I'm going to ignore that for the time being. Pretend that there is no strange protrusion. That's not a thing. Right, let's close the door behind me. This seems to be something that people complain to me a lot about. Go to the FTL room under the cockpit. I went down there didn't seem to be anything noticeable going on. The bloom has become J.J. Abrams levels of sentiment. Nice. I like it. There is multi-crew, yes. And yes, we are in elevator music, because what else are we doing at the moment, to be honest? No, this is Veilfilm music. This is the music I punched Morph to. I am pressing... don't tell me I can't interact with... Oh, shit. I threw the drill away. That's where my drill went. I had the other one on me still. Right. Good to know. Coming equipped for the fight. Rah. I think that's a Lotus level approach to drilling. Why take one when you can have two? Added benefit to strange protrusion. Well then. Fuck my life, I'm bad. It would be wonderful if the chat delay wasn't as such that just after I've died, I get to look over and see a raft of comments coming going, Helmet, what about Helmet?
Wasted, I think you should put on your helmet. Helmet, helmet, helmet. I was just like, oh no! Save me. Oh God.
All right, we're in control this time, however. I want to do some mining before we finish. I get the impression there's not a huge amount to do at the moment, because there's some mechanics that they clearly need to figure out and get working a bit better. I think it mostly seems to be, like, I haven't seen anything crafting related yet, or any method of doing any crafting. So there's a bit of that question of sort of hanging over everything. Like, how does that work? And if it works, how do you even begin it if there's not, like, that first station? You know, is it just going out and finding stuff? That'd be a bit dull. Love how there's a mining canister in this ship, but nothing else. Yeah, this doesn't have airlock controls. You have to manual override it. I just need to make sure I manual override the door again afterwards, which is what I messed up the first time. I turn my RCS on, probably help in here. I can actually turn around. Do you want to shut that door for me? Yeah, there's no proper pressure panel to depressurize this. You don't have an airlock to begin with. Oh, boof. Let's get the radar on, slow ourselves down a bit. Oh, hang on. We're rapidly approaching another ship. Oh, hello. What happened here? That was so much closer this time. Is that just because I got out so much quicker and they're drifting apart slowly? It must be. The ships do look kind of cool. There's a little bit of a slightly cartoony aspect. Hang on. Is this someone else's ship? I noticed there's two stations here. You can make stations from modules you find out in space. I see. So it's a sort of more of an exploration gameplay at the moment until they get some of the crafting and so on mechanics in. Which we knew weren't working anyway, so that's fair enough. I'm coming in! Definitely worth looking further into this, but this seems like one of these ones that's like quite of a long haul, if you know what I mean. A bit like Kerbal Space Program, for example, where, you know, they've gone simulation enough that it's going to take a while. You know, you're not going to just dive straight in there and get, you know, interesting and big setups really quick, unless potentially you're working in groups, which is of course what you'd expect in a multiplayer game, really, isn't it? To me at least, a lot of my early complaints can be definitely put down to the fact that I didn't understand what the hell was going on, and maybe they can make some of the controls and so on a bit more obvious, because to be honest, it is frustrating when you're expected to use controls that aren't listed anywhere. But the rest of it can be mostly put down to me being an idiot and doing things like opening two airlock doors at the same time, for example. You know, no one anywhere is surprised that that kills you or does something stupid. So yeah, it's kind of interesting. I'm intrigued. When it's this manual as well, I can definitely see the advantage of having lots of people helping, you know, get the community together. does that mean I'm on the floor, or does that just do a weird spin? Because that was the sort of angle I interacted from. I guess it must have been. Faceplant time! Oh, is it, Wraith? Nice. That's pretty cool, then. It's just about understanding what to expect from it. You know, I wasn't sure that... I wasn't expecting this much sim, which is not a bad thing by any means. It's just a different thing. Different to what I was expecting. I was not prepared for doing quite what we're doing here. So, really, what I want to do here... Apparently, the FTL works, so there is an argument about going to try the FTL, which is apparently done from down here. Let's fall down the ladder. Why not? So this is like the FTL room or something? Someone said it was downstairs, but like below the cockpit. It's called a... I took it. Can I... I probably want to put it back now. I don't think I intentionally wanted to get rid of it. I wanted to do whatever detonation things it was talking about. I can't say I'm seeing a huge amount down here, so... Back upstairs. Ooh, good animation. I see, so the... I'd advise you probably do something about that as well. You need to really orientate your arms in relation to the ladder, not in relation to the player's camera. Sorry, I'll stop that. I'm a bad person. Yeah, there's nothing to do over there. Let's grab some mining equipment. Oh, FCL's downstairs, we use it from the flight seat. Okay. Makes sense. AKA, Wasted, you are in the wrong place. Again. Couple of batteries, mining thingamy job, let's get upstairs. We got two things to try. We've got the FTL to try and we've got mining to try. Use the switches on the panel. Roger. Let me in the chair. Oh, I see. I see. What we got? We got engine, FTL. Scanners, headlight, docking, and nav. Oh, hell yeah. Now we're talking. And now we're very much KSP, aren't we? Look at those orbits. Yep. Yep. Oh, that's cool. Just one of these ones that takes a while to get your head around. Okay. Can I not turn my headlight on? I really want to turn my headlight on. Engines? Oh, hello. And this is how we turn our engines on. But they don't seem to be working at the moment. That was already mentioned, so let's not mess around with that too much. How about the footle? Bit of fast and light. Come on. Oh, something happens. Do I do it through nav? One might expect so. Objects in orbit 3. Add custom orbit. That makes the game kind of semi-lock up. Oh, God, what's happening? What have I done? Appa and Perry. Hello? What on earth have we got here? I was not expecting this. Really? That's fairly ambitious. Can we not change any of the other elements? No? Okay, so this looks like it needs a bit of work. Unless I'm missing out on some controls, which is probably likely. This, I can't add nodes. I can't adjust in anything other than apparently changing where our Apo and Perry are, which is not that helpful. If you can't change your inclination as well. Because like, this doesn't intersect with any orbits, nor can I change the node at which my orbit begins. So maybe I have to like move to a sensible position, but you don't have any of the other angles, you know? Screw it, should we just launch ourselves out into outer space? Cool, Jimmy Brandle. I'll have to watch their Let's Play. It sounds like... Oh, hang on. I've managed to move that now. Why can I now move that and I couldn't before? Am I... I'm going to have to go and check this out and maybe follow up with another stream. This was always supposed to be a first play, after all. And one of the deals with first plays is you do end up with some derpiness. There are distress signals out there, apparently. Where is it? Let's go get him. Oh, God. What on earth have I just done? Oh, it keeps locking up now. It's a completely different star. That's why. Go away, stop locking up, please. Every time I press a button, it's locking up at the moment. Get me out of the nav. Thank you. Yeah, everyone says click on a number at the bottom of the screen. I'm doing that and it won't let me change it. Stop doing that. So. Scan. I'm not actually getting anything. The problem. And I think that's because I'm locked in on something that's not me. I don't think that's me. I think that's something completely different. It's just some junk elsewhere. And screw it. There we go. Whatever. Do your shizzle. That has done nothing. Yeah, I'm somehow set on something that's not myself as a target. I've done a scan. As I said, it did a scan around this as junk. Am I zoomed out massively or something? Like, why is that all I can see regardless of what I do when I look around? Yeah, I need to look at some of the tutorials and so on. At this point, I'm not giving you guys a good experience anymore. We've gone beyond first play, and we've moved very much into the territory of a guy trying to understand some of the more complex mechanics in the game, and having no fucking clue what he's doing. Absolutely none whatsoever. So, my proposal is, I'm going to dive out of the airlock, try and find something to mine with our space drill of goodness, and if we can't, then I'm going to call it there. Certainly an interesting game, but one that warrants a good amount of time investment just to understand the mechanics. And while, you know, there is always that argument that, yeah, just check the tutorial and so on. If what you're trying to make is a game that people are actually going to play and enjoy, they're not all going to sit there and want to watch a lengthy tutorial. So I think some of this stuff, not necessarily could be more intuitive, but I don't know. It could be better explained somehow in-game. That would be really cool if there was some sort of more direct methodology. The only reason I've got anywhere this evening is because you guys in chat have been helping me out. It's like literally, that's it. Didn't kill myself this time. I was close. Not quite. You see, there was a bunch of people that were quick on the mark. They were right there. They were just like, no. Wasted. You are going to screw up. I know you're going to screw up because you've mentioned the words airlock. And that in itself is sufficient to tell me that things are going wrong in the very near future. And on that basis, get that damn helmet on, Wasted. Can I drill my ship? No, drilling your ship is not a thing. There's nowhere out here to drill. I'm in the middle of space. And this is realistic. It's a sim game. What was I expecting other than to slowly build up a graveyard of ships? I don't know. Not much. Hey guys, I need to go and check out some tutorials and learn how to play. And then I can come back and give you a more in-depth look at this once I've had a chance to actually learn about it. This was good enough for a first look. It's confusing. It's simulatory. It's kind of darkness of space feeling. I quite like it, to be honest. Definitely going to get back here, play a bit more. Thanks a lot for joining me, folks. It's something I've got to keep checking back with, because it's got those people saying KSP, it's got those sort of vibes, but from a space sim. I can't think how many other ones have even tried to go that like full sim with it. Even Star Citizen, you know, they're trying to include a lot of complex mechanics, but they're not trying to be a sim. Not truly. ED perhaps is a bit more sim, but it's not in a survival environment. Pretty cool. So, decompress my ship. Everyone, all right, let's end on a bang. Is there some way we can make it explode? Surely there's some way we can make it explode. I have to be able to end in a massive, like, Death Lotus ball of fire. Can I RCS thruster this thing into one of the other ones, maybe? Come on, there's got to be some epic trick to how to smash shit into other shit in this game. I left the airlock open. I've also lost control with the RCS completely. Fuck it. Let's just decompress her. Because that's nice and easy. There you go. Inner door. Confirm. Poof. Good night, folks. Thanks for joining me. I may well be live on Twitch a little shortly, but yeah, it was good fun. I'm definitely going to get back to this one when I have a bit of a better idea what I'm doing, because I was kind of bad. Just a little bit bad. But oh well. Goodbye, cruel world.